experience similar things when I was younger, but the experiences are a bit muddled, and I can't remember everything too clearly. It's kind of like bits and pieces, fragments, if you will, so I'm not really going to share those. And to be honest, even though I have experienced weird phenomena when I was younger, I really wasn't as scared as I was when I experienced weird things as I grew up, because, you know, that's when you start thinking, this is not normal, this should not be happening. So, I'm going to be sharing some recent scary experiences with you guys. Okay, so the first experience that I had was when I first started dating Jose, and this was probably a year into our relationship, and he started, you know, visiting the house more frequently and things like that, because my dad was very strict, so to have any boys over, that was like a big no-no. So yeah, it took several months until Jose actually started visiting my house, but yeah, I would say it was a year into it. I believe it was the summer, and this was in the house that I used to live in with my parents. The house has since been sold, and my parents are divorced, so I loved this house so much. This house will forever be my baby, and every time I drive by this house, I feel, I don't know, this like weird feeling, like, oh, like that's my house. I loved it so much, and it saddens me because none of my children got to experience that house, and that's the saddest part for me. But as much as I loved that house, I always got weird vibes from it. The vibes never really scared me all too much, but I felt like, you know, we're not the only ones there, if you know what I mean. But anyways, so this experience happened in the summer, and it was just about that time where Jose was going to head back home, and, you know, sometimes his parents would pick him up, and sometimes my parents would drop him off. So this time my mom was dropping him off, and I also had one of my other friends over as well, so we were just having like this, you know, hangout. And the like number one rule was that Jose could not go upstairs because that was my bedroom, and we had to abide by those rules or else Jose would not get to come over anymore. If you guys have Puerto Rican parents or Latino parents, you know how strict they are. And if you don't listen to them, you're gonna get hit by a jungle. But yeah, so we were all getting ready to leave, and I was already outside with my friend and with Jose, and we were on the trampoline. That was kind of like our hangout spot. And I had to go to the bathroom, so I went back inside, and when I got out of the bathroom, I heard Jose call my name. Now pretty much everybody calls me Sara, 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 but he calls me Sarai, and, you know, some of my friends from high school call me Sarai, but the majority of my family calls me Sara or Sarah. Voice, and it was saying Sarai, and it was coming from upstairs, and I was like, oh my gosh, he's upstairs, and now I'm going to get in trouble. So I like ran up the stairs super quick, in the bathroom. He decided to go in the upstairs bathroom, you know, no big deal. He was not in the bathroom. Then I checked in my room, and he was not in my bedroom. And then I proceeded to my mom's room, which was like across the hall from my room, and I heard my name again. And clear as day, it was his voice saying Sarai. So I'm like, oh my gosh, when I find this kid, I'm going to slap him upside the head, seriously. And then I went to my brother's room, because there was three bedrooms upstairs, and then the bathroom, which was my, like, private bathroom. But, yeah, so I, like, looked everywhere for him. Now, the weird thing about this house was that my room and my mom's room were basically connected. There was, like, this little, I don't even know what you guys call them, but, like, a cubbyhole where you would, like, store things. It was, like, this big storage closet, basically, that connects to one room to the other. Really, really weird. But the house was really old, and, yeah, we would hide in there sometimes when we were playing hide-and-go-seek. But as we got older, we kind of stopped hiding in there because it just gave us the freaks. So I was like, oh my gosh, he's probably hiding in there. So I went back into my bedroom, opened up the little cubbyhole, thinking that I was going to find him. Nobody, nothing. And I heard, once again, my name. But it was like almost vague, like almost as if like someone was saying my name, but like covering up their mouth, like it was muffled, but it still sounded like Jose. It was weird, and he was the only one that called me Sarai. So I just assumed it was him. So I look everywhere. He's not upstairs. I hurry downstairs. So as I'm heading to the car, I see my mom, like, and I'm thinking she's saying, like, where's Jose? But as I open the door, she's like, why'd you take so long? We're all waiting for you. And my mom had an STV, and I look in the back, and there's my friend, and there's Jose. And they're like, yeah, you took a very long time. And I got, like, instant goosebumps. I had a what-the-heck moment. And I explained to them what happened. And they were, like, I don't know if they were, like, flabbergasted or, like, didn't believe me. But, I know my friend, she, like, believes in all that stuff. So she was, like, shook. But Jose and my mom were, like, really, really. But all of them confirmed that Jose was in the car with them the entire time. And I know that they wouldn't lie to me for one. And like I said, my parents had all these rules. So, you know, they wouldn't lie. So he was in the car. So, I don't know, guys. That was so weird. And the fact that whatever it was calling me several times, and I would go to a different room, and, like, the voice would be far away, like, it would never be in that exact room, so the voice would just basically travel and make me have to go to different rooms, if you know what I mean. Like, it wanted me to follow the voice. I don't know, it's just, it's so creepy. Yeah, I'm getting goosebumps right now just thinking about it. Like, I remember the moment when I went into the bathroom and I, like, opened up the curtains, kind of like a scary movie, thinking that Jose was there and he was not. And then to hear the voice again and again and again. So scary. Yeah, so that was the first incident. So, this next incident also involves Jose. Do you see a theme here? But there was kind of like a gap. I had a twin size bed at the time because I didn't really like huge beds because I don't know, I always felt so empty. At that time, I actually slept downstairs in the spare room because I don't know, I would get like really weird vibes in my actual room, which was where the little cubby closet thing that led to my mom's room was. So because I felt really weird in my actual room, I slept downstairs. Didn't really help because weird stuff still happened. But yeah, so I felt this like heavy presence just like bam, just sit down on my bed. And I freaked out. I don't know, like I leaped to high heavens, like over whatever was sitting in my bed. And I quickly like turned on the lights, didn't see anything. And I just like opened up the door. The door was locked because I usually locked the door. I don't know, for safety reasons, I always locked it. But let me tell you, it felt like, at least for me, like ages until I actually opened the door. Like I was so scared that I couldn't unlock that door quick enough. It was so scary. And as soon as I got out of that room, I bawled my eyes out. Bawled my eyes out because it was just the weirdest feeling. Because to hear something, that's one thing, you know, you could almost like second guess yourself or come up with something rational to kind of explain why you're hearing someone call your name, like the first experience I had. But this was so different because I felt it like the bed just went boom and it stayed like that. It stayed like that. It wasn't just like a bounce. It just like plummeted and it stayed like that. I was just so scared. Like I still can't explain it to this day. But I felt the drop, but I also felt the presence. And the room just instantly got so cold. It was so cold. And once again, like, I have goosebumps. Let me show you. I don't know if you can see the goosebumps, guys. But no joke, like, these experiences mess me up, okay? But yeah, my brothers knew that I was just so freaked out. And I was really, I gotta say, amongst, like, my siblings, I was the strong one when it came to, like, weird things like this. Like, I would always kind of brush it off. I have lived with sleep paralysis since I was 4 years old, and all my life I have had really horrible hallucinations. I have dealt with the worst hallucinations. One of the worst hallucinations that I ever had was of my mom killing my father. And it was so vivid that it took me a moment to finally realize it was a hallucination because I thought that it was real. And I mean, I've seen the Shadow Man. I've seen a lot of things. But I've always brushed it off because I could, like, differentiate what was a weird phenomenon and a hallucination for my sleep paralysis. So I certainly do believe in paranormal things, but like I said, I've dealt with the effects of sleep paralysis all my life, that I know what's paranormal and what's not. And yeah, that was a very scary experience for me. And my brothers, they ended up like making me like a little makeshift bed and with a bunch of blankets and pillows, and I slept with them in the living room. We played some video games and they were just like trying to take my mind off. the experience that I had. And I mean, my youngest brother has some weird experiences, and his is more so one particular presence that seems to follow him around, and it's an older woman. Maybe one day I'll have him on my channel and he could share those experiences, because he's a really good storyteller too. Me, not so much, but he has dealt with a lot as well, even more so than me, because I have never seen like a full-on figure like he has. But yeah, that was really, really scary for me. So that was my second experience. The last two experiences happened in the house that I grew up in. This next experience happened in the first apartment I ever lived in after moving out of my parents. So I have to say, I always felt this weird presence in the house I grew up in. And I felt like when I moved, that weird presence followed me. I can't say it was bad per se, but it was just like I always felt someone there, someone watching me. It was unsettling, but I didn't feel like it was evil. But this experience definitely rocked me. So my daughter was, I don't know, she was probably like 5 months or so. She was very young. I will say I was a first time mom, so emotions were definitely heightened, and I barely got any sleep, and I was very paranoid. I mean, her crib was in our room, and it was just like an inch away from me, but I was constantly checking on her, making sure she was breathing right, making sure she was positioned right. So yeah, I didn't really get much sleep. But this particular day, I went to the kitchen. It was probably like 5 in the morning, because I do remember that it was about that time for us to wake up, eating Athena some formula, and then I headed back to the room, shut the door behind me. I gave her a formula, put her back in the crib, and I was going to get ready to go back to bed and get some sort of rest. And all of a sudden, I heard the loudest scream of my life. It was just like, ah, it was like a screech. I call it the banshee scream. It was so loud that it just filled the entire kitchen, the entire bedroom, and I can't even explain the noise. It was not normal. It was just so loud, so penetrating. And the scariest part is that my daughter got so scared. She just started screaming and crying, and it woke Jose up. Now, I still don't know if it was a scream that woke Jose up, or if it was Nathina crying that woke him up, because as soon as he woke up, like, the scream just, boom, instantly stopped, of course. So I tried explaining that to him. Once again, I was bawling my eyes out. I was so scared, so scared. It was just like the loudest scream ever. Like, it literally hurt my ears. And to know that my daughter heard it too just freaked me out even more. It really did. And that day I like packed my stuff and I wanted to stay with my mom, because I was not going to stay in that apartment. I was not gonna do it. No. So that's exactly what I did. And I remember that day so vividly, because I was freaking out. Like, everyone knew I was see what was up, and I can't explain it. The scream was definitely a female, and that's why I do describe it as a banshee scream. It was just the loudest, most penetrating screech ever. The scream was filled with pain. That's the best way I could describe it. It was like a scream of despair, and I almost could feel the sadness, and I'm not trying to exaggerate. It was just so crazy, and the sadness just kind of took over me, and that's why I felt like I just needed to leave the scene. Like, I could not be there. Jose was off to work, and I was just not going to be in that energy. I wasn't going to do it. And, I don't know, one day I'll ask my daughter if she remembers anything, but she was way too young. But, yeah, it was very interesting that she experienced it too. Like, she felt it or heard it. I really don't know, but she was scared. She was definitely scared. So, that was the third experience that I had. And the last experience that I had was in the same apartment complex, but I had moved to a different apartment that was much larger, because at this time, I had Luna as well, so I needed a bigger space. So, I have to say, I did not quite feel the same energy that I felt in the house that my parents had, and also the first apartment I ever moved into. For like the first year, I didn't really feel anything too odd, but then things quickly changed, and that is part of the reason why I decided to move, and we decided to get a house. So for the most part, I didn't really feel anything odd, paranormal-wise, but I will say that there was a huge decline in my health, even though, of course, there was always, like, reasonings as to why my health was declining, but it got really, really bad. I was losing my memory. At one point, the left side of my body was completely numb, where I was literally dragging my body to get from point A to point B. It was really, really bad, and I felt like my mind and my body were just deteriorating. I got to a point where I would just lock myself in a room, and I would just, like, crawl in up, like, into a ball, like, into the fetal position, and just cry. I felt like I was losing my mind, and even though I never felt anything, like, paranormal, I wonder if that was something, because the doctors, all they could really say was that it was my anxiety, and I have dealt with anxiety all my life, generalized anxiety, so I can say that, you know, I've moved away from that apartment, and I haven't felt that numb feeling. My mind feels clear, you know. I felt like I was in a haze, like I was in a fog, and at times, you know, I get brain fog due to my thyroid issues and things like that, but it was never to that extent, and I felt, yeah, like I was losing myself. So in a way, even though I didn't feel that, like, weird, like, presence following me, I felt something, you know what I mean? the second year, I definitely felt a weird presence. And I hated washing the dishes. Not because I was washing the dishes, but where I washed the dishes, it was like in a secluded little spot. And it was, you know, it didn't get much light, so it was always very dark. And I always felt like someone was behind me. I hated it so much. So, I just, I don't know, day by day, things just got really, really weird. My daughter, she's like an artist, okay? My oldest daughter, Nathina. And she would always draw me a picture. Like, every day she would draw me something. And it was always very cheerful, very happy. The pictures started to change. The pictures got dark. And, you know, at first I was just, you know, not really thinking anything of it. You know, kids have an imagination and, you know, it's just a drawing, right? But the drawings just got worse and worse and worse and darker and darker and darker. It wasn't in her personality to draw something like that. And I got to a point where she would just draw multiple images of this like dark figure with like dark eyes, and it was really, really creepy.
I'll just show you, this is how she usually draws a person. So there's one there, just so you can see. This is another one. And this is another one. Now, the picture that she drew today is completely different to the way she draws, different to her character. This is what she drew. And, you know, I'm not trying to make something out of this. But is it a coincidence? Is it just, I really don't know. It's completely different to something that she would typically draw. I mean, so I did ask her, I'm like, you know, what is this, you know, well, I tried to act like, oh, the picture's beautiful. So explain the picture to me. And she said it was her.
You know, I discussed with Jose that things were just not working out in this apartment, and I just didn't feel safe, and I didn't feel right, and I wanted to just leave. And, you know, at this time, I was still doing YouTube, so I was still filming on my beauty channel, and I was still filming my ASMR videos as well. So, this is where the, experience happens. Paranormal. Whatever phenomenon, I don't know what you want to call it, but it's free. And I actually have a video clip, but I was filming a Halloween haul, and this was back in 2016. So I was just starting to film ASMR, and I believe I started my first ASMR video in August, so this was around October, I'm guessing, because it was a Halloween video. So, I was just, you know, like, tapping on things, and I think at this particular moment, I was tapping on a pumpkin. It was like a light-up pumpkin, and I heard my name. I believe it said, "Hey, Sarai." I will probably leave it here. It almost sounds like my voice, which just makes it wasn't until I played it back when I was editing that it really freaked me out, because like the evidence was there. Now, as you guys know, I always film really, really late. It's just better for me. It's quieter. It's just, it's easier because the kids are asleep. There's no extra noises, you know what I mean? So that day, I filmed late as well, and my kids were asleep. Jose was asleep. You know, he had to go to work the next day, so there's no explaining it. Now, my father lived upstairs, and my brother lived upstairs too. Now, it wouldn't even matter because they don't call me Sarai, so it definitely wasn't them calling my name. And even then, like, it wouldn't pick up. Like, they live in the top floor, but like trying to justify like who would call my name, obviously my daughters would not call my name. They would call me Mommy, not Sarai. And the only one that calls me Sarai is Jose. So it just didn't make sense. Like, my friends do call me Sarai. My best friend calls me Sarai. But like I said, it was a woman's voice. It sounds very much like my voice. There's no explanation for it. Now, during that time, I felt static within my body. And I felt this, like, the best way I could describe it was just like black. Like, I felt the color black. I don't know, it's really weird. But the door was slightly open, and I felt the color black, and I saw the color black. It was like as if someone just like zoomed by, and it was a black image. I didn't see anything like really crystal clear, but just black, and it was really weird. I could feel the presence. It was very heavy. Was always really cold, so I can't really say that the room got cold, but it was always just really chilly in there. So I have the video footage. I will leave it here. I actually had a paranormal experience while filming any ASMR video, and you can see from my face that I am genuinely confused and freaked out. And I know that whatever that was not anyone that I knew. Like, it was not Jose, it was not my daughters, no one in that apartment. So the funny story